Hi students, welcome to the another session, part 2 of our discussion, chapter number 11, that is water in our life. In the last session we were talking about what are the measures used to how the water is helpful for different various activities in our life, for drinking purpose, for washing the clothes, for cleaning the houses. Not only that, we have various activities in our day-to-day life with the help of water. We were talking about that, and we were talking about what are the measures used to measure the volume of the quantity of water. Okay, if it is small quantity, we will measure in mls. If it is somewhat more, we will measure in liters. The water in the tanks, overhead tanks, it is measured in gallons. Okay, and in such case we talk about cubic, the water released from the reservoirs, we are talking in the cusecs, that is cubic centimeters. We were talking about that. Today we are going to discuss about activity 3. The continuation of this, today we are going to talk about activity 3. And the aim of the activity is how much water do we use daily? How much water do we use daily is the question that what we are going to answer. Okay. See, water, we use water for different purposes. Can you estimate how much water we used in a family in a day? Okay, record your estimation in the table number 1, and also think how much could be reduced the amount water used, and write how much water we can save. So also think, how do you reduce the amount of water, and write how much water can be saved, is what it has been given. So the table number 1 shows that, table number 1 gives the information about different activities that we perform and used water, how much we use water used and how much we can save. How much water we can save. These are the 3 columns we have in the table number 1, which are going to help us some concepts. Okay. So the activity, first activity is drinking. For drinking, we use 2 liters of water. 2 liters. For drinking purpose, we use 2 liters. How much we can save? We cannot save. Okay. No saving. We cannot save anything. Okay. For toilets, we use 10 liters. For toilets, we use 10 liters. Where we can save 5 liters of it. Can use 5 liters. Bathing purpose, we use 30 liters. Where we can save 10 liters. For bathing purpose, we can use 30 liters. We can save 10 liters. For washing clothes, we use 60 liters. Where we can save 20 liters. Okay. For others, we use 80 liters. Where we can save 30 liters. Okay, so total, that is 182 liters I utilize. How much I can save? 65 liters I can save. Okay, the usage of water in our for various activities in our day-to-day life is 182 liters I consume. Amount of water I consume. But amount for that I can save 65 liters of water. Okay. So to estimate in the liter the amount of water used, you can take a liter bottle, and to find out how many bottles of water is needed to fill a bucket or a glass or a mug. So how to calculate, suppose if you have used a bucket of water, how can you know how many liters a bucket full of water is being used. For this purpose, what you do, you take a empty 1 liter water bottle and try to fill the water bottle, try to fill this bucket with the help of that water in the water bottle. Check how many water bottles have come. Suppose if 15 water bottles are filled, that means one bucket full of water can hold 15 liters of water. Like that we can estimate the amount of water utilized in liters. Okay, now see, whole day we use for a day, okay, that is what it has been given. So now find out how much water is used in a whole day by you and your family, and also calculate the amount of water you and your family were able to save. See, for this is for only by a single family. Okay, now how can we can save? You have a rough idea of how much water your family uses in a day. With this information, you may able to calculate the approximate quantity of water required for a colony or village or town. For this, you need to know the population as well. Now ask your teacher about the population. Okay, so we need the population also. But there are some things we are going to calculate here. See, approximate quantity of water used per day by a person. Okay, by a person. So if I take one person is using, from this calculation is using 182 liters. One person is using 182 liters. Okay, whereas in a village, number of people in a village or a colony, for example, okay, or people in a colony or village, for example, there are 1000 members, suppose. There are 1000 members, suppose. So approximate quantity of water used per day in the colony. So the water used per day in the colony, per day in village, is equal to. So how much amount of water is used per day is equal to 1% 182 liters into 1000 members. That is, okay, 182,000 liters. 182,000 liters of water is used by a village per day. Okay, per day 182,000 liters we are using per day. Okay, now approximate quantity of water used per a month in the colony. Now, so per, this is per one day we are using this much. Now per 1 month, per 1 month it is 182,000 liters into 30. Okay, it will be giving as 182,000 into 30. If you do that, okay, that we give that is equal to 5 crores 46 lakhs. Okay, 5 crores for one day, 182,000 liters we are using. So for 30 days we use 5 crores 46 lakhs liters of amount of water we are utilizing per 1 month. Now approximate quantity of water used per a year. Okay, if this is for 1 month, now per one year, the approximate amount of water per 1 year, okay, that is 5 crore 46 lakhs liters into, so 12, if we multiply, that is 66 crore 52 lakh liters. 66 crores 52 lakhs liters amount of water is consumed by a village in 1 year. See how much huge amount of water is utilized by one village in a year. Now if you assume that, and if you assume the total world and concern how much amount of water is utilized per year. Okay, it's a big value. Okay, so imagine how much water is needed across the world. Concentrate, if one village is using 66 crore 52 lakh liters of water per 1 year, okay, assume how much amount of water should be utilized for the entire world. Assume how much big figure it will be. Now where do this water, okay? Now the next question is, I hope you understood this activity. The next question is, where do we get where do we get water from? So the next, see, we get water from different water sources in our surroundings. So the next, the question is, where do we get water from? Okay, so we get water from different water sources. Water sources in our surroundings. The most of that are, so we will get the wells. In villages, we get the wells. Canals, tanks, we'll get ponds, we'll get rivers, we'll get the water from bore wells. These are the water sources. Okay. Where do we get the water from are called water sources. So the water sources, these are the water sources. So the source from which we get water for doing various activities are called water sources. Okay, the water sources may be wells, canals, tanks, ponds, rivers, and bore wells also. Okay, we get water. These are water sources. Get water, and the cycling of water cycling process due to the rains and all, we are going to get the waters. Okay. Now list out the sources where do we get water in our village and town, or the sources where do we get water for our daily needs and crops are the same. Okay, so in the for daily needs and the crops, the water source is the same. Someone will have bore wells, and some crops depends on rain water also. Okay, some crops depends on rain water as well. So what are the water sources? Where do we get the water from? From the water sources like this. Okay. So one do you know block is there, very interesting do you know block we have here. So under the do you know block, see, water is not only available in the sources such as rivers, lakes, and ponds, but also present in certain fruits and vegetables. Okay, under the do you know block, water is available. Available in certain fruits and in certain vegetables also. So water is not only available in in water sources like rivers and ponds, they are available in the fruits and vegetable also. Okay, fruits like watermelon and vegetable like cucumber contains a lot of water. Okay, fruits like watermelon vegetables like cucumber contain more huge amount of water in it. Okay, not only this, our body also contains 75% of water by the weight. Okay, our body contains 70% of water by weight. Okay, in a way, our body also contains some amount of water. That is 70% of our weight. Water is going to contain. Okay, so water in our on the earth is being given. So, understood all of you? Do you know block? See, the water not only from the rivers, ponds, and wells, such water sources, they will be available in some fruits, vegetables, and not only that, our human body also contains 70% of water, by the way. Okay, vegetables like cucumber and fruits like watermelon contains water in them. Next is water on the earth. Okay, water on the earth. See, there are different sources of water. As of now we discussed, till now as we discussed, there are different, see, there are different sources of water on the earth. Okay, we know that nearly 3/4 of the surface of the earth is occupied by water. Okay, now we have, just now we discussed that there are so many types of water sources available, and if you take our earth, some rough sketch I'm drawing here, if I take our earth, 3/4 part, okay, 3/4 part of earth surface is occupied by water. So how much? 3/4%, that is approximately 75% of the earth surface is occupied by water itself. Can you drink the water available in the sea? Is the question. Can you drink the water which is available in the sea? Sea lo dorke water ni manam tagagalama? Okay, obviously not. Okay, the water in the sea is salty. Okay, the sea water, see, the sea water, the water in the sea is salty. The water which is present in the available in the sea is salty, but we use, so, but water used by us in the daily purposes is not salty. But the water what we drink, see, the water used for drinking or washing or all activities, our day-to-day activities, okay, water used for day-to-day activities is not salty. Okay, they are called, this water is known as fresh water. Okay, this water is known as fresh. This water is known as fresh water. The water we drink, the water we use for the clothes, washing the clothes, the water we use for the various activities in our day-to-day life is considered as fresh water. It's a fresh water. Okay, now water in the ponds. Okay, where do we get the water? Water in the ponds, okay, water in the puddles, water in the rivers, okay, water from tube wells, okay, and water in our taps at house is usually a fresh water. The water we are going to collect from these all sources is usually a fresh water. Now this is what has been given. So in the next segment we are going to talk about activity 4, where we are going to discuss about this activity 4, that is safe drinking water stages. Okay, meet your panchayat officer and collect information about safe drinking water scheme in your village. Don't forget to prepare a questionnaire for interview. Display the observation on the wall. So first, in the water purification in the villages, the water purification under activity 4, so as per the activity 4, we have safe drinking. So activity 4 is the safe drinking water. Water stages. So the same drinking water stages is been given. The water from different sources like ponds, rivers, borewells is been filled in a tank. They will be filled in a tank. The water in the tank, they will be filled from different sources. They will be filled in the water. Water is filled in the tanks, and from that they will be filtered. They will be passed. The water will be passed through a filter. Where it is passed to the filter to get rid of. To separate the dust particles and some impurities, sand particles, dust particles, any impurities like some insects and all, if their leaves, any husks, wood husk, chatta, some type of leaves and all. If any impurities or dust particles are present, with the help of filtration, it will be filtered. That filtered water is sent through a through the pipes. It is sent through a chamber. It is sent in a chamber. The water is sent into another tank or another chamber. This is another chamber where the aeration takes place here. So aeration takes place here. So what is mean by aeration? Aeration is nothing but the aeration is a process to. So it is a process of circulating the air here with respect to some fans, with the help of some fans. Fans, the aeration process is executed. So we circulate. Air is circulated. Circulated to form water bubbles. Water bubbles. Water is circulated through the water to form air bubbles that removes the gases. That removes the waste gases. Gases present in water and maintains presence of oxygen in water. So in the aeration segment, in the aeration chamber, there will be some fans. Rotating in that circulation. Air is circulated with the help of fans. So through the water to create air bubbles, to remove the waste gases and to maintain the presence of oxygen. From this chamber, again it will be sent to a tank where chlorination is being done. Chlorination is been done. In this chlorination chamber, chemicals in the chlorination process, chlorine or chlorine compounds. Chlorine compounds such as sodium hypochlorite. sodium hypochlorite is added to the water. Okay, in the chlorination process, either chlorine is added, a chlorine compound called sodium hypochlorite is added to kill the germs and bacteria. What to do to kill the germs or to kill the bacteria, germs or virus or microbes. Microbes, if any such are present in the water. Okay. After the process of chlorination, this water is sent through the overhead tanks. This water is filled in the overhead tanks. From this overhead tanks, it will be supplied to the taps. From that overhead tanks, it will be supplied to the taps. So this much process has been happening. Okay, from water is collected in the water from the different sources like rivers, ponds, and all. It will be collected in the tanks. Then it will be going to the filtration process to remove the dust and some impurities. And from that, it will be taken to the aeration chamber. In the aeration chamber, the air is circulated through the water to create the water bubbles. That creation of water bubbles will remove the waste gases and to maintain the presence of oxygen in the water. After aeration process, it will be taken into the chlorination chamber, where in the chlorination process, a chlorine or chlorine compound is sodium hypochlorite is added to this water to kill the germs, bacteria or any virus and microbes if any present in that. After the process of chlorination, it will be sent or it will be filled in the overhead tanks. Okay, from that overhead tanks, it will be supplied to the water taps which are allowed, which were there in our household in that village. From that, the human beings or the village people will utilize that water. Okay, so this much process has been done. These are the drinking water stages, different drinking water stages, where this process is helpful for making the water available from the water sources to undergo to the different process and made safe to utilize or safe to drink by the people in the village or town. Okay, this is what is the small different stages which are present in the filtration under activity 4. I hope you understood this session. Tomorrow we'll continue with activity 5 and what is drought and what is floods. How to prevent that and all, which will be the conclusion of our lesson by the 3 parts. Okay, thank you all of you. Keep smiling and please subscribe our channel to give the motivation to us for uploading the videos, different videos. Okay, thank you all of you. Have a nice day. Keep smiling and bye-bye.